Hi, I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Best of the season, everyone. And as promised, our next Christmas Carol style shift will involve taking a look at making Joy to the World into a reggae number. And as I mentioned in our last video, the Deck to the Halls jazz conversion that we did, when you're converting any piece into another style, it's very important that you think about both the rhythmic meter and the chord voicings and chord harmonies that most correctly fit with the style that you wish to move the piece into. So let's take a closer look at my arrangement of one of the most popular Christmas carols, Joy to the World, but in the reggae style. When it comes down to the conversion of Joy to the World into a reggae style piece, what I did first of all is I broke the harmony down into only three chord types. I've just got the root, the four chord, and the five chord. And since this is in the key of G major, that turns into G, C, and D. You don't want a lot of harmony, and you certainly don't want to go overboard on chord substitutions and things like that, because the reggae style is a fairly simplistic style, you know, whether you're dealing with rhythms or with the harmony of the piece. Now, let's also just quickly talk about things that have to do with voicings, because off the initial set of chord changes on the intro, see, I moved along the neck. I'm only playing G and D and C chords, but I'm going along the neck with them just to add a little bit of variety. You'll hear that in a lot of the reggae players, and you listen to some Bob Marley and so forth. You can hear these guys moving along the neck quite a bit. So what I've also got in the idea in terms of rhythm is I'm really focusing quite heavily on the backbeat. So with reggae style, you're going one and two and three and four, and you get that the up of one, two, three, and four, and that's the principal meter that you're following. So with that, combined with small chord voicings, and of course maybe varying them a little bit to add a little bit of motion along the neck, you're really going to quickly start getting that reggae sound almost instantly. Now, in terms of the melody, I just kept the melody very simple. And I moved it kind of along the neck a little bit. I was functioning between about fourth position all the way to maybe about eighth or ninth frets here. And just kept it in sort of one region. I kind of like those string sets dealing between fourth and second. So that was my main focus. I didn't really use any notes on the first string, and I didn't really travel past fourth string. I just thought between fourth and second strings, fourth, third, and second, gave me a really nice sound in the melody. Something that you want to almost consider with any tune of where you're going to place it on the fingerboard. Now, one other thing is, you know, embellishments. Reggae is a style where it's going to mix a lot of elements together. You'll have bluesy sounds, you'll have lots of pentatonic sounds, of course, and you'll want to try and add in some pretty cool ideas in terms of hammer-on pull-off concepts, slides, you know, that kind of thing. Come up with some of your own ideas on how you want to embellish these things. On the tab chart that I have that's associated to this lesson plan, there's really not much of any embellishments at all. I think I put one slide movement in there, and that's pretty much about it. But, you know, aside from all that stuff, when it comes time around to solo, of course, because this is a traditional piece, you'll want to really try and adhere to that original melody of the piece you saw in my opening video demonstration of the piece. I was doing some different kinds of third intervals, you know, just matching the melody during my lead section. But for the bulk of things too in that lead, you know, especially in the reggae style, you want to kind of stick with that pentatonic sound. So it's G major. So I was using lots of G major pentatonic. You can add in a little bit of blues flavors if you want to, but for the most part, it's just major pentatonic and the odd little cluster of ideas, of course, out of the major scale. And that's pretty much about it. Well, as I had mentioned in our last lesson, converting a piece into another style is not a particularly difficult thing to do, but in order to have a successful rearrangement in the end, it will take some experience. Because you basically need to have a good footing in the style you'll be moving the piece into. And, you know, I hate to sound like a broken record here, but you need to understand both the rhythmic meter and the harmony of the style that you're heading over to for this to work well for you. So thanks for sending in all the great questions in regard to this topic, and I hope you've gained a few new skills that'll allow you to convert a piece into another style when you may need to do this in your future musical adventures. So thanks for watching. You can download the handout for this lesson over at my website at andrewwatson.com, and you can follow me on Twitter and through Facebook for updates throughout the week. The links are all in the description box below. Take care, everybody. Happy holidays, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.